Hi guys, welcome back to Ribbons and Relics. I'm trying to be a little bit quiet because Bo is right behind this wall in his swing sleeping. So I have a quick little craft haul for you. I've gotten a few things from Hobby Lobby and then a few things from Dollar Tree. So I'm going to jump right in with the Hobby Lobby stuff. This week their spring, anything labeled with their the spring shop was 40% off. I purchased three of these little boxwood spheres. Here's all three. They were originally $3.99. I got them at 40% off, so I paid just a little over $2 for them. I'm not sure exactly what I'm gonna do with them. I think I'm just gonna place them around here and there in the living room on shelves, maybe place one on a little candle holder. I'm not exactly sure. I might throw them all in together. We'll see. But I needed some greenery around the house and I thought those were perfect. I actually had some larger ones originally. I could only find two of those though. Those were $7.99, so they would have been just a little over $4, which isn't a bad price for the size that they were, but I wanted three, so I could only find two of the bigger ones. The smaller ones I found three of, so I just went ahead and went with those. But really, really cute. I'm really excited to find those. I grabbed some more of these burlap bows. I've hauled them previously. I only have a few left. I used them all as some decor for a baby sprinkle. These were also 40% off of $2.99, so just under $2 I paid for those. These I found on clearance. I paid 49 cents for these. These are just envelope seals. They're stickers, the letter R. I'm going to do some upcoming Happy Mail for three of my friends. So one of them is Rachel, so I got her the R. And then another friend of mine is Willow, so I got her the W's. And I couldn't find the proper initials for the third one, but I did find some H's. My last name starts with the letter H, so I stocked up and got two of those for myself. Let's see what else is in here. Oh, and then here is an iron-on letter R for 24 cents for my friend Rachel. It's really silver, silvery, sparkly, really, really pretty. I found some ribbon on clearance. This was 49 cents. I don't know if you can see that. And just really skinny, kind of a maroon color, burgundy color with white polka dots. I really liked that. I thought it was pretty. They had a lot of ribbon that was under a dollar on clearance, but a lot of it was really pretty, but I just couldn't think of a project that I would use it for, so I ended up not getting it. This was also with the clearance ribbon. And this is like an elastic. So what I'm gonna use this for is to make hair bands for myself, really pretty. But this was placed with the clearance stuff because there's no clearance sticker on it, so someone just stuck it there. So I ended up getting this for half price. It's originally $3.99, so I just paid $2 for it, which isn't terrible. And then the last thing that I picked up from Hobby Lobby was a refill for my little glue guy here, and I wasn't sure what brand I had or which one I needed. So I don't know if this is even the right one or if it's even gonna fit in there. It looks like it might, and I feel like this packaging was familiar to me. So hopefully this is the right one. If not, I kept my receipt so that I could return it and get a different one. That's everything that I picked up from Hobby Lobby. When I've been to three Dollar Trees around recently around me, and I've been looking for bins to organize all my craft stuff. So I mean, I kind of don't even want to show you because it's really a junky mess, but I'll let you take a look. It's right over here next to me. I'm sitting at my craft desk. I have all of this on the floor. I have all of this here on my desk. I have all of my stickers, all of my ribbon, and then over here on the shelves, some of the higher up shelves are my husband's stuff. He's very tall, he can reach up there. But then, like, I have my washi, I have some extra bins. So I have been looking for bins to organize all of this stuff. And I haven't found anything big enough at the Dollar Tree. I needed something not only that had like a big bottom base, but something that had very tall sides. Like, I took my washi from one bin that it was overflowing from and dumped it into a bin that I thought was bigger, but it was more shallow. So it's still like overflowing even out of that bin. So I needed something with a bigger base with taller sides. I haven't been able to find it at all three of those Dollar Trees that I went to. So I went to Hobby Lobby looking for bins, hoping to be able to find them, you know, for just a couple of dollars. And I did. I actually found quite a few different bins that could work. But the ones that I liked the most were $6 a piece. They were really nice, really sturdy bins, but I really didn't want to pay that much. And when I pulled into the Hobby Lobby, I don't know, complex or whatever you want to call it, I forgot there is a Dollar Tree there. So I went into Hobby Lobby, I looked at all their bins, got prices, and then I decided, you know, before I go ahead and purchase any of these bins, I'm going to run down to this Dollar Tree. And sure enough, I was able to find bins that hopefully are going to work. I'm pretty confident that they're gonna work. I'm not psyched about the blue color, but I am happy that I was able to find all one color. I ended up purchasing 8 of them. They're really, really deep and tall. Well, deep and tall is the same. They are very, like, I don't like the ones that have like the sides that go out like this. I like the sides to be more straight up. That way when you're putting them all side by side on the shelf, you're not losing a whole bunch of space in between them. They all kind of just slide together. So I ended up getting 8 of these. I probably could have gone online and gotten all of them in white if I wanted to, but, you know, I was so excited to find them. I didn't really even think about it at the time, and I just went ahead and grabbed them. There are more, a lot more of these blue too. Still at that store, so if I need to, I can go back and get some more. Hopefully they'll still have it. And then I also picked up these, like, I don't know what you call these. I call these like magazine holders. That's what I've always thought they were used for, but I'm going to use them for my padded envelopes. I have a whole stash. You probably saw when I showed the camera because they're down here on the floor. I have a whole stash of just like padded envelopes. So I'm gonna line these up on the shelf side by side. I was gonna get these in blue, but the blue was like a different blue. So I decided to just go with a whole different color. I thought the two like similar but not quite the same blues just looked too weird next to each other. So I ended up spending $11 just on the organization for the bins, but I think that's not bad at all. And I shouldn't have to get any more. In fact, I should probably have some left over that I don't end up using. So hopefully, if they hold as much as I need them to, I should have some left over. I also picked up an 8-pack of these file folders. I am, for my Happy Mail, I think I'm going to attempt to do flip books. I've never made flip books before. I've watched quite a few videos on YouTube of flip books, and one, actually I watched quite a few of them that were using file folders. One in particular, I think I'm going to try and copy. So they did have file folders at Hobby Lobby that are already decorated, so you wouldn't have to use any of your scrapbook paper to cover them, but it was like $6 for I don't even remember how many were in there. It wasn't very many. It was like 8, maybe not even that many. Some of them I think might have been a dozen for like $7 or $8. So like I said, I would rather just spend $1. Dollar Tree did have, I think, 6 packs of file folders that were different colors. So like they had a pack of red ones, blue ones, nothing really with designs or decorations like Hobby Lobby had, but I have a ton of scrapbook paper, so I'm just going to cover them myself with my scrapbook paper. I also picked up twine. I had a huge roll of twine. I don't know what happened to it. I know that I used it for the baby sprinkle, but I don't remember using all of it. So I can't find it. It's probably in one of these bins here somewhere, but I did find a 3-pack of twine at the Dollar Tree, so I just went ahead and picked that up. And then I ended up grabbing 3 of these note cards with envelopes, just 3 different designs. You have to be careful. I picked up ones that have 8 cards with envelopes. They do have a lot of packs that only have 6. So if you're not too picky about what design is on the front, then I would get the ones that have 8 cards because you're getting more for your money. But if you want it to specifically say something, or you like one of the, you know, designs on the front better, you can just get the 6 cards with 6 envelopes. But I did watch another flipbook tutorial that just uses the cards and envelopes, and that was a really cute one too, so I may attempt to do that as well. I think I'll do one of each, one flipbook with the cards and envelopes, and one flip book with the file folder, and then decide which one I like easier, which one I think is better, and go from there. You guys, that is everything. I'm surprised. I thought I had a little bit more. I'm probably going to attempt to make a video of my craft organization. I don't know how that's gonna go. I can't promise that I'm gonna have that video up for you, but I am going to try to do that. I know my other craft embellishment organization video that I have has the most views out of all my videos, so I think that's something that you guys would really like to see on this channel. I think that'll do well. But thanks for watching my little craft haul, you guys. Have a great day. Bye-bye.